For two decades, this weathered cross in North Carolina was a piece of a dreadful puzzle.
It's been really hard for my family to wrap our heads around this.
Natalie Mosteller lives in Covington. She grew up surrounded by family in Brown County, including her first cousin, Bobby Witt, and his mom, Myung Ha.
They were at our house all the time. You know, we loved them and we loved being around them. And Bobby, he was so sweet. He was such a good kid.
But after Bobby and his parents moved to North Carolina in the mid-90s, Mosteller never saw or heard from her happy-go-lucky cousin again.
It's mind-blowing that anybody, let alone his father, could do something like this to him.
Until a few weeks ago, Mosteller thought Bobby's mom had taken him to her native South Korea. She says that's what her uncle, Bobby's father, told people. Now she says Bobby's dad, who's been in federal prison for years, has admitted he killed his 10-year-old son and Myung Ha 2 decades ago.
His confession just brought it all home, and it was like another punch in the gut.
Before DNA helped police crack the case, Bobby Witt was only known as the boy under the billboard because his unidentified remains were discovered at the base of an advertising sign.
Unfortunately, that is how he is known across the country, and it's sad.
While tormented by the circumstances, Mosteller is grateful her aunt and young cousin will soon be coming home.
They are going to be buried next to my grandmother in Mount Orb, Ohio. I'm just glad that he finally has a name now and that people know what his name is and they know that he will be brought home.
Now, the North Carolina detective who spent the last 20 years investigating this tragic case retired 6 days ago, the same day he closed this double murder case. The detective said he couldn't think of a better way to go out. Todd Dykes, WLWT News 5.